Hi there, everybody. Michael Valenti here with the School of Self-Defense in Indianapolis, and today I'm going to be answering one of the questions that I get asked more than any other question, and that is, can you prepare my kid or my teenager to defend themselves in college in a very short period of time? So the answer is mostly no with a little bit of yes, and this is really important to understand. Let's start off with the mostly no. Self-defense is a physical activity. Hopefully you agree with that. It's something you're using your body for. Any physical activity takes a long time to get good at, and it takes sustained effort to get good at, and it takes continuous practice to stay good at. Think about someone who trains in boxing. They may train in boxing for 6 months before they get into the ring and have their first boxing match. And when they get into the ring, there's still a strong chance that they will lose their first boxing match. Why? Because martial arts is hard. Fighting is hard. It takes a lot of time to get to the point where you can reliably beat somebody who's even at your weight class. It takes even longer to get good at enough so that you can reliably beat someone who's bigger and stronger and more powerful than you. And you may be saying to yourself, well, of course, that's true in sports because you're not allowed to cheat. And I will tell you, in the School of Self-Defense, we put a heavy emphasis on striking to the eye, striking to the groin, striking to the throat, using headbutts, elbows, eye gouges, knees. We do the quote-unquote dirty fighting. But the thing is, if you have nothing to back up that dirty fighting, what happens if you try to kick them in the groin and you miss? Or you try to poke them in the eye? And you miss. You have to have something to back up your cheating. The idea of self-defense being a thing where you do a quick move, and the person lets go of you and you run, is usually not realistic. The fact is, you really, to successfully defend yourself, you have to be fighting back. You cannot just simply try to get away. And to have the skills to fight back reliably and confidently takes time, takes effort, and takes continuous practice. And I would love, from a business standpoint, I'd probably make a lot more money if I lied to you. If I said, sure enough, in three easy lessons, I can prepare your daughter to protect herself. I'd probably be a far more successful martial arts instructor. But the thing is, I have this weird hang-up called morals, and I have to tell the truth. And the truth is, no. In just a handful of lessons, I cannot turn your daughter into a badass. And I'm sorry if you're someone who doesn't want to hear that. Because a lot of people I will tell this to, and I feel as though it goes in one ear and out the other. It almost seems as though they don't really want me to give them an answer. They want to just hear the answer that they'd like to hear, right? They don't want the truth. And the truth is, it's a physical activity. How long does it take? Asking me how long does it take to get good at self-defense is like me asking you how long does it take to get good at cooking, or how long does it take to get good at gymnastics, or how long does it take to get good at football. It's different from person to person. Some people have an aptitude for it and catch on very quickly. Other people literally never really get good at it because they don't have an aptitude for it. They get better at it, but becoming really good, it really depends on how much effort you're putting into it and how long you're training. So that's the no side of the equation. What about the yes side of the equation? Like I said, that it's no and a little bit of yes. And the yes is this. If I have someone in front of me and I know for a fact that they're only going to train with me for 4 sessions, I am not going to focus that much on developing their sidekick or developing their, positional strategy in ground fighting. I want them to have basic tools, so, you know, strikes like eye jabs and elbows and basic ground fighting things like trap and roll and, you know, shrimp escape and things like that. But probably the number one thing that I'm going to focus on is the psychology of self-defense. Understanding the psychology of an attacker, who's the kind of people who actually attack you, how do you end up in a victimized situation, how you can avoid being in those situations, the psychology of it. And that's something that we can do in a very short period of time. So it's a yes and a no. The no part is that the physical side of it really is something that takes a long time to get good at. However, it's not something that is completely unrealistic to have someone come to me and train with me for a short period of time, because I can at least give them some tools to help them avoid those situations that maybe they wouldn't have otherwise. Just get them thinking in the same way that a self-defense practitioner thinks goes a really long way. Because statistically, self-defense practitioners almost never get attacked. I mean, it's incredible how rare it is for someone who studies martial arts to be attacked, and it's because we generally move through space differently than other people. That we don't, there's a lot of little rules that we follow that prevent us from becoming a target in the first place. So that's kind of my little two cents on it, I guess, that when it comes to self-defense, understand you are fighting someone bigger, stronger, and more powerful than you, and that takes a lot of time and a lot of effort to get good at. And to believe if anyone's out there telling you that they can prepare you in just three easy lessons, they are a con man and they know nothing about what they're talking about, and you should run from them. The truth is, the physical side of martial arts takes a long time to get good at. The intellectual side of martial arts is something that we can kind of cover in a shorter period of time. Getting you to the point where you can identify an aggressive opponent, getting you to the point in which you have learned basic skills like situational awareness, conflict de-escalation. Once you have those skills, it really helps you avoid the fight. And then having a couple tools to back that up is nice, but I prefer you to have a full arsenal to back it up as well. So if you are interested in studying self-defense with us at the School of Self-Defense here in Indianapolis, all the information to do so is at our website, theschoolofselfdefense.com. If you live too far away to train with us, we also have training opportunities via our Patreon, so head over to our Patreon and check that out. We also are on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter, so give us a like and follow us and all that stuff. And of course, don't forget to like, favorite, comment, subscribe, and click that bell button all here on YouTube. So until next time, everybody, I'm Michael Valenti with the School of Self-Defense. Fight on.